Skål and welcome my friends, I'm Horath Drak and this is my short combat tutorial for Expeditions Viking. There are five concepts that you have to wrap your head around if you want to do combat successfully. There is action points and actions, there is cover, there are attacks of opportunity, there's flanking, and there's switching weapons. Right, let's just start with the first one. So the combat is turn-based, and each turn you get two kinds of actions, each of your characters. They get a movement action, signified by this green dot, and they get an attack action, signified by this red dot. Inside this green area, you just use your movement action, and you can still attack after moving, or you can move after you've attacked. But you can also expend your attack action for an increase in your movement. So if I move inside this yellow area, I will convert my attack action into a movement action. Can move further, but have to forgo the attack. Different actions require different amounts of action points. So for example, there are free actions like throwing this rock or using the ranging shot from an archer. There are actions that just require one attack action. So you could still move afterwards if I were, for example, just do the normal attack or use the swipe or whatever. Then there are actions that actually require your full turn, like the aimed shot from the archer. If I use that, I can't move afterwards, and if I move, then I won't be able to use that if I, for example, were to put him into some form of cover. You can change the actions that you have in that bar down here by clicking on this button, clicking on one of your guys, and then just dragging and dropping whatever you want at whatever place you want it in your quick bar, because sometimes you need different actions. Right, second concept that we need is cover. So there's full cover and half cover. This archer, for example, is in half cover, as signified by the half-filled shield. Over here, behind this rock, if a person were standing over there, we would have full cover, like this character, for example, has. Both provide complete cover. The difference between them is that archers, for example, can shoot over half cover. They can't do that with full cover. They have to step to either side of the cover to actually get a shot off. The other difference is that you can get flushed out of this half cover. If a character stands right next to you, you have to stand up and engage with that character, and that'll negate your cover. And the ranging shot of an archer also denies you the cover if you're in range of that ranging shot. So that's the main difference between those. Right, next thing is attacks of opportunity, and that ties in nicely with the changing weapons. I think we're going to do that first. So characters can switch between two weapon sets freely until they make their first attack. That is true for each turn. So if I switch my weapon now, make an attack, and next turn I can switch again. So it is kind of beneficial to actually not use a bow in melee. And why is that? Because we have attacks of opportunity. If I were to shoot my bow right now, with that attack, with that ranging shot, you can see that all these arrows pointing towards my archer over here signify that I would take four attacks of opportunity. That would obliterate me. I think that will kill my archer. So instead of doing that, you might want to switch to a melee weapon, not take all these attacks of opportunity, and just take a normal attack on one of these guys, not taking all the attacks of opportunity. That's a very good idea. Attacks of opportunity also occur if you move behind a certain character. So let's say, how are we gonna do this? How are we gonna play this? Yeah, it can sometimes be beneficial to move around characters, take the attack of opportunity to actually get some flanking off. Flanking occurs when one character is between characters that are opposite of each other. So if I move over here, this character and my character will flank them. I'm gonna take those attacks of opportunity. They can't really do too much to me. Each character only has one attack of opportunity by default. You can skill characters so that they have more than one attack of opportunity. Right, so you can see that this guy is now flanked. We're gonna do a lot more damage to him, and his damage reduction is reduced as well. That is beneficial. It can be worth the trade, taking the attacks of opportunity to position yourself in a better way. And I think that's about it. So think before you use your actions, use your free actions. The throw rock is a bit of an oddity because it does not pull an attack of opportunity for some reason. So you can do that every turn if you skill it. That's interesting. Most ranged actions will take an attack of opportunity if you use them, as well as I think healing when you're standing next to an enemy and all that kind of stuff. So I hope that helps you with your own combat. Use the ranging shot to flush enemies out of cover. Plan your actions. Watch out if you're about to use a full turn action and leave your person out in the open. And yeah. Have fun playing Expeditions Viking. If you found the video useful, please leave a like so that the video can show up in search results. If you didn't, or if you have any questions, then please leave it in the comments. And if you want to see more of my stuff, then please consider subscribing to my channel. I do hope that you join me in one of my videos. Thanks. Bye-bye.